Hello, hello, my lovelies, and Happy New Year! In the new year, we all start to plan. That's why I want to show you how I do it and how some other people do it, so hopefully, you'll find some ideas how to adapt the style to suit you, because we're different and different things work for us. I use the system called Bullet Journal, and you can read more about that at its creator's page, but in a nutshell, it's just a notebook, a simple notebook, and all you need is a notebook and a pen, and that's it. There are, of course, many types of bullet journal, and you can make it elaborate or not as you like, but basically, you just need a notebook and a pen. What kind of notebook, you might ask? Well, it can be gridded notebook if you really like very geometric designs. And it's important to you that every part that you make is the same width and the same length. This is really easy to use. But of course, it can be limiting if you have more artistic goals and you want to paint and color in it, and these lines might feel too obvious for you. But I'd always suggest start with what you have. You can even use it in a normal lined notebook. Personally, I hate this one the most, but for people who also use bullet journal to actually journal in it, it's probably the best one. It's good for writers. For the most artistically inclined, of course, the best is probably just plain notebook. It can be white or off-white, cream colored. Some even use black and they use white gel pen in it. But this one gives you a lot of freedom in terms how you set your layouts and in terms of decoration. But of course you have no guides, so that's the downside and you have to measure everything. That's why there's another variation that is dotted, and this one is probably the most used and the most practical because it gives you more freedom than the gridded and the lined, but still some structure. You don't have to measure everything. What kind of pen to use? Well, that depends on what you plan to do in it. Personally, I love this Pilot pen the most for writing, and I use fine liners and pencil and eraser for the sketch. Why is it called bullet journal? Because you make bullets of tasks and events and everything you have to do, and you're also supposed to journal in this notebook. Personally, I don't journal in these expensive notebooks. I got this one from my daughter, and there's no way I will just use it to scribble some thoughts. It would feel too precious. I just use normal notebook to journal. Now let's see how we can set it up. One part of the bullet journal are the lists, and the other part are the plans, future plans. And in this video, we'll focus on yearly plans. Basically, that's a year at a glance. I've drawn some setups here, and I'll put this picture on my blog so you can take a closer look. But basically, what you want to do is put all of the month, or at least half of the year, or part of the year, onto a two-page spread. These are all two-page spreads, and you can see the different layouts that you can do to write the events and the tasks that you know that you'll have to do in a certain month. It can be horizontal, and you can have fit all 12 months into two-page spread. It can be vertical with all the months on the two-page spread. You can add a little calendar at the top below the name of the month, or you can make a 3x4 or 4x3 or whatever style you want to. Personally, I usually like to make it on two double spreads. So I have 6 months at one page, at one double spread, and 6 on the other, because I find that it's not a problem for me to flip the page, and I really need more space. 1/6 of a page is just not enough for the whole month in the future for me. But that depends on your planning, on how many different responsibilities you have and you want that you have to write down so you don't forget. Of course, if this is even not enough space for you, you can do it on even more pages and fit just 4 onto 2-page spread and then just flip through as you need. Some people don't jot ideas down and they just make a calendar for the whole year, just with dates and maybe some cover for the year. And some people use this mix where you have dates on one page and then tasks on it on the other. I really like this idea, although I haven't used it yet, but you make a calendar that you stick onto dedicated space for the month. So when you flip it over, you can write down what you need. I like this idea a lot, but I will probably never use it because this space would just not be enough for my needs for planning for 1 month. But somebody might find it really useful. Even these that have 12 months at 2 pages is not enough. For me, this works well, or I can make them horizontal. It's probably even better, depends. Now let's see it in action, how it looks in my old bullet journals. I started bullet journaling in May of 2017, and that's why this spread has months since May till December. But as you can see, I quickly found out that this is just not enough space for me. I had to really squeeze everything, and I couldn't fit everything that I wanted. So in my next bullet journal, I used more space and I made 4 months per 2-page spread. Then I tried another variation, a vertical, also 4 months per page, per 2-page spread. And then I also tried again to fit everything on one page, but it still didn't work. I thought maybe something changed during this time, but it hasn't. So in my next bullet journal, I will make more space for each month. If you want to make my day, give this video a like and subscribe for more art. If you don't want to miss my next video about how to set up bullet journal monthly, be sure to click the bell icon so you get notified. Bye bye and see you next week.